Assalamu alaikum student. Today we discuss the topic that is the diffraction of light wave. In this video we learn how to interference pattern produced by wave that is diffracted by passing through the gap and traveling different distance. To get a sense of we know that light from a light source travel away from the source in all direction. Light wave from a source travel away from the all direction. Here we take the barrier that is containing a small gap. This small gap is placed near a light source. Here is the light source. Here is the gap that is known as the slit. We can see that here these wavefront become longer as they move away from this gap that is known as the slit. Wave that pass through this slit is change the direction. It is important to understand that change in the direction of the light wave is neither due to the wave being reflected or neither due to the light being neither due to the light wave is reflected. So here it is important to note that waves that pass through the slit change direction. Change in direction of light waves neither due to the reflection nor due to the refraction. Light wave can change in direction due to the reflection and refraction. However, the phenomena that we describe here in this video is separate from the reflection and diffraction. In both reflection and refraction of the wave must be incident on a boundary between the region containing the substance with different refractive index. In both reflection and refraction, we require two medium 1, and this is the medium 2, where the phenomena of reflection and refraction is happen. But in this case, we cannot use the different media. We use the only one media. In this case, we use the same medium either side of the slit or within the slit. We use the same medium. So here is the no change in refractive index occur. The process of light changing direction being incident at a boundary between the region with different refractive index is called diffraction. So the process of light wave changing direction being the wave incident at the boundary between the region with the same refractive index is called diffraction of the light waves. Now we define the diffraction of light wave. What is the diffraction of light wave? It is the process that light waves changing direction without the waves being incidents at a boundary between region with different reflective index is called diffraction. Diffraction does not only occur at the slit. Diffraction also occurs when light wave move parallel to the surface and reach the end of the surface. When they reach the end of the surface, they also produce the diffraction pattern. So here we write diffraction does not only occur at gap. Diffraction also occur when light waves travel parallel to the surface and reach at the end of the surface. Here we show the diffraction angle of the diffraction of light wave. What is the diffraction angle? The amount of direction changes of the waves is called diffraction angle. The diffraction angle for a light wave that is passing through the slit This is known as the diffraction angle. This diffraction angle depends upon the width of the gap and the wavelength of the light that is diffracted when it passes through the gap. So the diffraction angle depend on the width of the gap and wavelength of the light. The angle of diffraction is maximum when width of the slit or gap is equal to the wavelength of the light. The angle of diffraction must be less than 90 degrees. That is all about the diffraction of the light wave. Hope you like my video. If you like my video, please subscribe and share. Thank you. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum student. Today we discuss the topic that is the single slit diffraction. We know that the photo slit, the phenomena we study, that is the interference for single slit, we use the phenomena that is the diffraction. For study of single slit diffraction, here we take the narrow slit, that is the AP, width is lambda. Here we take the single source S that produce the light. This produce is made the monochromatic light by placing the lens. When light is passing through this lens, that become parallel. This parallel light is passing through this narrow slit, and when they passes through this narrow slit, they fall on the screen S. When they passes through this lens, this light is converged through the center point O. So we see the bright image at the center of the screen X, Y. When the light is passing through the slit, it is become diffracted, and this diffracted rays is focused by the using the converging lens, which converges the light on the point O. This point O is known as the central maxima, because here the waves are reached, are in phase, and they interfere constructively and make the bright image, and the angle is here is theta is equal to 0 degree. So here we define the central image when a wave from slit AB are focus at the center O of the screen, then wave from slit reach at point P, they are in phase and they interfere constructively, form bright image. So here we found the bright image. This bright image at the center O is called central maxima at angle theta is equal to 0 degree. So this is we discuss the central maxima when the diffraction is happen in the single slit diffraction. Now in single slit diffraction, we discuss the position of minima. Position of minima is formed when the destructive interferences happen. Here we take the wave, that is the wavelength is that path difference is total is the lambda. When path difference is equal to the lambda, so here we write the path difference p is equal to lambda. If we divide the wave into two half, this become the lambda by 2 and this become the lambda by 2, then the path difference will become lambda 2 and they interfere destructively. So the wave from this phase and the wave from this phase, they interfere at the point P. They interfere destructively. When they interfere destructively at point P, so here the dark fringe will be produced. So here for first minima, we take the path difference that is equal to the lambda. For second minima, we take the path difference that is the 2 lambda. For third minima, we take the path difference is equal to 3 lambda. For nth minima, we take the path difference that is equal to the p is equal to n lambda. We know that the path difference that is here denoted by p is equal to the sine theta, that is sine theta is equal to n lambda. For small angle theta, sine theta approximately equal to theta, so here we can write d theta is equal to n lambda. So here we can find theta is equal to n lambda over d. For first minima, that n is equal to 1, the angle which diffract the wave is give us the first minima position is equal to theta, 1 is equal to lambda over d. This is for the first minima. So this angle is for first minima. For second minima, theta 2 is equal to 2 lambda over d. For third minima, theta 3 is equal to 3 lambda over d. Yes, so in this formula we can find the angle in which the dark fringe is produced in on the screen. Now we find the position of maxima in the single slit diffraction at point P. For this we take the wave that path difference is equal to 3 lambda over 2. So if we divide the slit into 3 equal part, then each part that path difference is equal to, that is the lambda by 2. This is also lambda by 2 and this is also lambda by 2. When the wave from the two pair, wave from this part and the wave from this crest of the part interfere, they marry destructive interference, and the first and the one wave that is left, their path difference is lambda by 2, that when they reach the point P, they make the bright image, but this bright image less than the central maxima. So here we write the wave from the two half interfere constructively and third half will produce some intensity. So the wave from two half, this is first half, this is second half, from two half interfere constructively and where and wave from third half will produce some intensity, destructively, and wave from the third half will form bright image at the point P. So here we write that is the bright images form at point P when the path difference is P is equal to 3 lambda by 2. So here we write for first maxima that we obtained, that is the path difference is equal to P is equal to 3 lambda by 2. For second maxima, the path difference will be 5 lambda by 2. For third maxima, path difference is 7 lambda by 2. For nth maxima, path difference is
is equal to nl plus half lambda. So we know that part difference at p is equal to d sine theta. So here d sine theta is equal to n plus half lambda for small angle sine theta approximately equal to theta. So here we write d theta is equal to n plus 1 half lambda. So we can find theta is equal to n plus half lambda over d for first write theta 1 is equal to, here we put n is equal to 1, so it is equal to for first write, that is n is equal to 3, so it is equal to 3, sorry, here we put the n is equal to 1, when n is equal to 1, put in this formula, that is equal to 3 lambda over 2 d. Similarly, we can calculate for second write. Second write, we put here t theta 2, n is equal to 2, so we get 5 lambda over 2 d, that is the angle for the first bright image, and d, that is the angle for the second bright image. That is all about the position of maxima at the single slit diffraction. Now we discuss the intensity distribution curve on the single slit diffraction. In the x-axis, we take the diffraction angle, in which angle the rays are diffracted. In the y-axis, we show the intensity of the diffracted rays. At the center point, intensity that we get the interference rays is the maxima. At the second intensity is minimum from the central point, because the third half of the wave is produced the intensity, and next intensity is less than the third half of the intensity, because the fifth half of the wave is produced the intensity of the wave. So in this point, they shows the maxima on the screen, and this point is shows the minima on the screen. Minima point is in which angle if we get the lambda over d, first minima we get at 2 lambda over t, second minima 3 lambda over t, third minima up to so on. Similarly, we get the first maxima in the lambda over 2d angle, and the second maxima we get at angle 5 lambda over 2d, and third maxima we get at 7 lambda over 2d. This is all about the intensity diffusion curve of the rays that are diffracted on the screen and produce the maxima and minima fringes.